Radiation is one of those terms that people don't understand very well, and because of that, they often fear it. In fact, I get an occasional email asking me about the radioactive dangers of particle accelerators and big industrial accidents like Fukushima and Chernobyl. These inquiries are often prompted by someone seeing some lurid video about how we're all going to die, and that sort of information just irritates the heck out of me. Ignorance is one thing, but willful misrepresentation of science is, as far as I'm concerned, criminal. And the same thing goes for when companies play down what is sometimes very real danger. Now, I'm not a radiation occupational health expert, but that doctorate in physics has to be worth something. I do know a thing or two about radiation, so I thought it would be a good idea to make a video that helps you, the viewer, understand the truth about the dangers of radiation. Okay, so let's start. When I say the term radiation, what do you think about? Do you think about a monster awoken by nuclear bomb tests? Or a man irradiated by gamma rays? Or another man bitten by a radioactive spider? These are all very common associations of radiation in cinema, but I have some really bad news for you. None of that is even remotely possible. That's just not what happens. The problem is, of course, that we have no real experience with radiation. We can't touch it or smell it or feel it. It's just there, and well, that makes it scary. So, is radiation dangerous? Well, yeah, it can be, no question about that. Standing near the core of an unshielded nuclear reactor is a very quick way to kill you. But some nuance is necessary, because radiation isn't an either or thing. Things are more or less radioactive. For instance, it might shock you that I am radioactive. This banana is radioactive. Your basement, radioactive. How's this? You are radioactive. And here's a startling one, your mom is radioactive. Given that you're probably not worried about yourself, your mom, or bananas, it is pretty clear that something being radioactive is not, in and of itself, worrisome. It's the amount and type of radioactivity that matters. I'll talk about radiation type in a separate video, but in this one, I'll give some more general information so you know the right kinds of questions to ask if you see a video on television or the internet talking about radiation. But before I do that, I want to show you how it's really easy to give you a wrong impression about radiation. Let's start with this radioactive material. I can show you that it's radioactive by using this Geiger counter here. Those clicks you hear occur when radiation hits the detector. The clicking rate doesn't sound super scary. But let's try it again. I'm going to bring the detector close to it again and listen to what you hear now. Whoa, that is way different. Tons of clicks. Sounds scary. But the object didn't get more radioactive. So what changed? What changed is that I increased the sensitivity of the detector. It makes more clicks for the same amount of radiation. There's a real-world example that can show you what this means. You all probably have some experience with a microphone or stereo. And they have a volume button, which is all you need to turn this into this. So if someone wants to freak you out over radiation, they just have to turn the sensitivity of the radiation detector up to give you entirely the wrong impression. Of course, a person wanting to play down what might be a very severe situation can do the opposite, and by turning down the sensitivity, seemingly turn this into this. The bottom line is that when it comes to radiation, there is dangerous radiation and not dangerous radiation. And if you want to know if you should be worried or not, or if you can take a nap, you need to know more and in a more detailed and quantifiable way. So there is a unit of radiation dose called a sievert. This unit is a measure of the biological damage caused by radiation, but you can just think of it as like degrees, but for radiation instead of temperature. If you're a super healthy person living in a cabin out in the woods, far away from technology, you will encounter about 0.003 sieverts of radiation each year. So that gives you a sense of what's normal. If you're like most people and live in some town or city, you'll encounter more radiation. On average, if you have normal dental work and maybe an occasional x-ray for a sprained ankle, you'll double that. So most of the people watching this might encounter something like 0.006 sieverts of radiation per year. I said that you were radioactive, which is true. If you're curious, the radiation dose you receive from yourself in a year is about 0.0004 sieverts. And if you fly across the Atlantic Ocean, you're looking at something like 0.000025 sieverts of radiation. So what about some bigger doses? If you're unlucky enough to need a whole body CT scan, you're looking at 0.01 sieverts of radiation. By the way, a whole body CT scan is something doctors might do if they need to look inside your entire body. What about people working in nuclear facilities? They are limited to receiving a maximum of 0.05 sieverts of radiation over the course of the year, or about 8 times as much as they get just living their daily lives. Most, of course, receive much, much less. Okay, so those are the safer levels of radiation. What about the ones that are less safe? 0.1 sieverts, or double the maximum allowed dose for a radiation worker, is the dose where there's a noticeable increase in cancer risk. 4 times that at 0.4 sieverts will cause radiation sickness if the dose is received over a short period of time. 5 times that will bring severe radiation poisoning that is sometimes fatal. That's 2 sieverts. Double that at 4 sieverts and it will usually kill you, although sometimes with excellent medical care you might survive. And finally, at 8 sieverts, you're dead and there is nothing that can be done about it. But this is a lot of radiation, over 1,300 times you normally get in a year. So that was a lot of numbers, so this graphic kind of lays it all out. Okay, so what does that mean in terms of places you might go? Well, standing for 10 minutes inside the Chernobyl reactor is over 8,000 times the normal annual dose, so it'll kill you very, very dead. So don't stand there. I really hope I didn't actually need to tell you that. How about something a little less dire? Suppose you decided to live for a year in the Fukushima Forbidden Zone. I found some numbers on the web, which means I cannot verify that they're true, but let's say that they are. They say that if you did that, you'd receive 0.03 sieverts, which is about a quarter what you need to have a detectably elevated cancer risk. So it seems like a perfectly sensible thing for the Japanese government to forbid people living there. On the other hand, if you needed to go in for 12 hours to do something, that's 0.0004 sieverts, which is equivalent to a flight across the Pacific. So that's not so dangerous. And this underscores an important point. Staying in a radioactive spot for a full year is more dangerous than standing in the same spot for half a day. That should be obvious, but these sorts of nuances get lost in some people's descriptions of radiation. So is there any merit in some people's worries about eating fish from the sea? Well, fish caught very near the leaking Fukushima reactor site should be avoided. But what about fish caught, for example, off the California coast? It's true that scientists have detected Fukushima radiation in seawater and fish, but that's just because the instrumentation is so sensitive. But where does the dose lie on our chart? We can use tuna as the worst case scenario. Remember how people used to avoid eating tuna because of the worries that they contained mercury? That's because tuna are apex predators and they contain toxins from all the fish they've eaten and the fish those fish have eaten and so on. And what scientists have found is that the meat from tuna fish caught off the coast of California is significantly less radioactive ounce for ounce than bananas. So it turns out that seafood caught far from the Fukushima site does have a small amount of radiation that sensitive equipment can detect, but it's safer than eating bananas. And who doesn't love a good banana? The bottom line is that we live in a radioactive world. Radioactivity is not always dangerous. Remember, you're radioactive. Even your mom is radioactive. On the other hand, radioactivity can be very dangerous. Just ask Tokyo. But when you hear about it on a news report, you really need to know the numbers to know whether you should worry or not.